Cheers.
Hey everybody, welcome to Fairy and Jar Farm. We are in the Ocala garage, shameless plug. Link to the other YouTube channel below. Today is going to be extraction day. So I posted a video that I'll link up above the other day from extracting honey from my flow hives. And you know, there's a lot of controversy about the flow hives. Some people hate them, some people love them. I've had success, I've had failure. But the one thing that cannot be beat is how easy it is to extract honey from the flow hives. So check out that video and then watch this one. Matter of fact, I'll make it easier on you. I will go ahead and kind of do a little overlay. I'll show us, you know, a bit of the extraction from the flow hives, and then we can compare it to the old school way. You kind of have to do it if you have, you know, more than like two colonies, because let's face it, flow hives are expensive. So today we're going to use, I don't know if it's in frame here, let me roll you down a little bit. We've got our Hilco six frame medium, three deep extractor, nice little electric one I got at Hive Life last year. I've got some of these Hive Butler totes that I've modified one to use as an extraction tank, although you can buy extraction tank Hive Butlers from them, maybe do that next year. And then we're just going to kind of go through, you know, you can see I've done a little bit already, got some honey coming out. I've already got 1 5-gallon jug, and I also got about 5.5 gallons out of the flow hives. So we've got about, 13 more mediums to do, and we're going to just go through kind of the process with that. And let me get in frame here. So once my wife joins me, then we'll go ahead and get to recording just what it's like to do a kind of manual honey extraction, kind of the old school way where you have to cut the cappings off the comb and get it into the spinner and do all that, and then filter it through into a bucket. So we'll kind of go through that process, and you guys can compare and contrast between this process and the flow hives and decide if you want to spend money and risk bees not using them, or go old school and still have to spend money on an extractor and mess. So I'll leave that up to you guys. Stick around. How'd you know I was filming?
I didn't.
For you?
Thank you. And little puppy. Where's the little puppy? There you are. Hi, little puppy. You're a movie star.
She's like, where's my beer? I want a beer.
You want a beer, puppers? Come get.
Don't you.
I'm not going to feed her a beer. Oh my goodness. All right, so here's the tools we're using. I've got a nice, expensive serrated knife, which I should probably get a cheaper one that's a little bit more flexible than this one. We got the little, whatever this thing is, comb, and a little rubber spatula.
Oh, yeah.
What?
Comb.
It is a comb, I
guess. It is. I know.
It is. All right.
All right. So, what do you want me to do?
Stand there and look cute. Done. Are you in frame?
Nope.
You're not in frame.
Nope. I'm like, I can look out cute all you want. Nobody else can.
There, now you're looking cute. Now you're looking cute on TV. Let's see. Do. Okay. Are you getting bored already? You're singing. All right, just in frame. All right, so look at that. That is a beautiful frame. Look at that.
It is, actually. I kind of want to draw on it.
I missed a little bit, but...
Ah!
Ignore that side. Look at how perfect! Okay. So I have a little nail in here, and I just put a frame...
Why do you have a nail in there?
I'm glad you asked! So I can set this on here and spin it around a little bit easier.
That's so smart!
I know, I'm wicked smart. If I were smarter, I would have... cut the top off, the flat top of the nail, so it was more pointy, and it would kind of sit on there
impale
better.
Impale people? Yeah.
Yes, impale people. So I take the knife and kind of just cut a little bit of an angle, like this. Try not to cut the wooden frame too much. I'm just cutting off the cappings as much as I can. Now these frames I didn't, like, I put left 10 frames in a 10 frame super, so the bees didn't build it out very wide. Mm-hmm. But if you space them out so there's 9, the bees will build the comb thicker, so you can do a better job cutting
Faster, smarter.
Yeah. So I'm just using a serrated knife. You can use one of those other like comb knives or whatever, and then heated ones, all kinds of fancy stuff. What are you doing, young lady? You spit
like
it out.
Wax.
I don't like the wax either. I don't know why you're eating it.
I didn't. It's on the floor.
Yeah. So when the girls don't build it out very deep, the knife isn't going to do a very good job on capping. No, that's not wood.
Oh, that's weird. It's like the same color as the wood, and I don't have my glasses on, so there's that too.
And so that's why I have a little comb, just so I can.
And does it make a difference which if you start from bottom go to top or vice versa? I figured it's flowing down, so it would maybe be less messy if it was hot out. We're inside.
Yeah, we're in a nice air-conditioned space. Well, it shouldn't because there is no really up and down because this is the down.
No. I'm meaning like go down this way so you're not like getting honey all over yourself and your tool. Mm-hmm. But
you mean like this way?
Yeah, it's harder to see.
Yeah, it's harder. I can't. I'm not
coordinated
enough.
So that's a good thought though is if you're going to do this outside, you might want to not do it on a day that's 90 degrees, even if you're standing in the shade, because this is probably going to get really drippy out in that deep.
Yeah, you also don't want to do it when it's really cold though, because then it won't be drippy enough.
Exactly.
So, alright, this one is almost all pulled off. Alright, so, and then I'm wondering, I bet we're going to get almost a gallon of not wax, but honey out of the bottom of this thing, too.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, I think so.
Alright, so, then the frames, probably should move the camera over here to show that later, but the frames fit into nice little slots in here, which you guys can't see right now, but we'll show you later.
Think of a peace sign, you know.
Yeah. Alright.
And it has to fit into one of the triangle areas of the piece then.
Cute puppy break. Viper, say hi to everybody. You can tell everybody hi. Look. Hi, everybody. Hi, everybody. Say, my name's Viper. I'm super cute. Are you super cute?
Super cute.
What? Super dork over here.
Super cute. Super cute puppy! No, Daddy, don't do that. Okay. Alright, I'm going to take this off the thing and show everybody the stuff and the deal. Because it's all technical.
The real deal.
Alright, so here I've got the honey gate open because we had some in there from extracting earlier. And I bought one of those like double mesh things that you can get from like Man Lake or wherever. And so it's double filtered screens, and then beautiful honey down below. I'm just letting this pour out right now. And then here's the extractor inside with a big spinner deal. And so the frames go this way. The thicker part goes out here, and then it rests in a little channel on the bottom. Can't quite see it. And then when this spins, we'll show you when it's spinning, it just flings all the honey out. With the medium frames, you don't have to turn them, you just put them in like this and spin until they're empty. But the deeps, they go the other direction. So you have to spin for one side and then take them and flip them all over and then spin it to extract the other side. So the mediums are a lot quicker. You can do higher volume and just get it done faster. One thing you do have to be mindful of though, as smooth as this motor runs and as balanced as this thing is, if the comb is, you know, one is thicker on one side and it's really thin on the other, this thing is going to rock back and forth, and you'll probably see that because that one's kind of a thinner comb. And then we've got some thicker ones, but we only have 10, 11, 12, 13 total frames left to extract.
You know what they say, if the extractor's rocking, go fix it.
Go fix it, yeah, balance it out. Yeah, that's smart. All right, here's how they all fit in. And one of the kind of cool things about this is it sort of like holds in the loading position. So it seems to kind of just sort of stop in the like the loading position, which is kind of nice. All right, so I'm gonna close this down. I'm gonna come over here, and the only thing I know how to do on this thing is press the power button. Everything else, I don't know. And then we're gonna slowly turn this dial up.
That's two things.
And then you can see it starts spinning. And then I'm gonna continue to speed it up. I'm gonna go, let's see if we can get, you can hear it.
What do you put it up to?
I put it up to however high I can before it starts bouncing around. Kind of see it, you can hear it, but you kind of see it flinging onto the side.
You can definitely hear it.
Yeah. All right, we're gonna go a little faster. Now you can see it's starting to shake just a little tiny bit, a little bit quicker.
So if it does start to shake too much, you just put it down a notch?
I just dial it down a little bit.
How long do you let this run?
Until I don't hear it flinging stuff off the comb anymore, which could be 5-10 minutes, whatever. All right, we'll come back after it's done flinging. So enough honey has flung out. This has actually balanced itself, so I've got to go on full speed. And I don't know if you can see it, but it's just flinging honey onto the outside wall of the extractor unit, and then liquid gold is just pouring out of the bottom. That's almost done, but I'm recording again because I want to show this. Ta-da!
Yay!
All right, so this is the setup I use to clean out. You got hold of the bottom bucket?
Yeah, hold of it.
Okay. So this one, actually, I still have stuff in it. And so it's got this little very thin mesh. It's a paint strainer, but you get them brand new and you can use that. And then this has little holes in the bottom. And then this has a hole in the top, and I'd put another paint strainer in here.
If you have something like this at home already and you like go camping, don't use this one. Use a new one. Just saying.
Why you gotta go there? Anyway, so the top bucket drains through the hole in the bottom bucket, and you have wonderful, pure, clean, nice honey in the bottom bucket, and then you've got all your little wax stuff in the top that you can melt down for wax stuff. It's very technical.
Do you have something? Oh, you've got the netting inside there.
Yes, hand me that. This is the stuff that I use. Come on, focus camera. There we go.
Okay.
This is the stuff that I use. I just get it at, you know, Home Depot, Lowe's, whatever, in the paint section because it's strainers for paint. And it fits the five-gallon buckets. Thank you.
You're welcome. I mean, we're just going to meet all these people on the street corner and...
That's not old-fashioned.
Well, it's, yeah.
All right, I'm cutting this part out. So that's honey extraction the traditional way as opposed to the flow hives. So feel free to compare and contrast and see if it's worth the money for flow hives or not, because those cost money too. Anyway, thanks for tuning in, guys.
Thanks.
Yeah, you sure?
Go start.
I always start.
Finish it.
Be good.
Finish
be well.
You.
I will kick your ass. Hi. Thanks for tuning in, guys. I hope you come back after we have...
Whatever.
Mm-hmm. Be good. Be well. Be safe. Be happy.
Bye.
And be good to the...
Bees.
Be mindful of the bees. We need them. And they give us nice honey.
Me. Hi.
Shut up.